little bit.
A little bit.
Great honor to be with you today. Our 62nd Game Warden Academy graduation. Let's give it one more round of applause.
Our lives are made up of a series of moments. Some stay with us.
Congratulations.
And a few will change our lives forever.
Dr. Crowder, you earned this badge.
Thank you. Yes, sir.
I made it.
I'm so incredibly proud of you. That's just incredible, son. I love you.
I love you too. Thank you.
I did three. Shoot several because somebody always blinks.
For Zack Stevenson, this is a momentous day. He is now officially a Texas Game Warden. But this day might never have happened if not for one weekend a decade earlier.
Where's this one coming from?
It's going to be number one. It's going to go out straight away.
Pull.
Very good. Good shot.
It tested like everything, like how much, if he knew how to lead and if he knew where it was coming from and followed through with it. I did all right.
Good.
When I was a kid, you know, I wanted to be outside and I wanted to be out hunting, and I was raised by a single mother, so I told my mom I wanted to go hunting, and she didn't know where to start. She didn't know the first thing about hunting.
Parents and all that, I want to thank y'all. It's going to be a lot of fun this weekend.
What we do is we offer a program. We can furnish the firearm, we can furnish the ammunition, we furnish the place to hunt. All they have to bring with them is desire to go hunting and enjoy the outdoors.
Gentlemen, y'all get in line. Get you something to eat.
She had a friend that was a part of the Texas Youth Hunter Program, and that's how we found out about it.
What time are we getting up?
We're getting up at 5 o'clock, like normal time.
5 o'clock in the morning?
Uh-huh.
So. This isn't for tomorrow afternoon?
No. 5 o'clock in the morning.
It's going to be deep at first, but it'll end up being about this deep when we get to walking, so just stay in single file.
For me, because I did grow up relatively close to Houston, I didn't get to go out a whole lot.
It's something that he wants to do. That's something he can do forever.
Get him!
They've started out with the gun safety.
All right.
That was actually pretty fun.
It wasn't near as bad as I was thinking it was going to be.
While we were on that youth duck hunt, we actually had a large group of game wardens come out and talk to us. And it was the first time I'd ever heard about what a game warden does. That was the day it clicked for me. That was what I wanted to do. And pretty much since that day, I just started working towards it.
The moments that make up our lives are interconnected. One leads to the next, eventually shaping who and what we are.
So you're volunteering to go first, right?
Nope. Have you ever seen an alligator?
Oh yeah, I've seen them all the time, yeah, but there's a difference in seeing one and then handling one.
Watch this thing, because this thing will come up and get you.
All right.
There you go.
Hold on to
it.
Hey, quick, you gotta be quick.
Push it down when he's flush on the ground, then curl your fingers up and lock it in those jaw bones. That way, if it's pushed down, you know that mouth is closed.
Okay. There you go. Work it underneath there. All right, whenever y'all are ready.
One, two, three.
Good job.
I believe it's the finest training in a law enforcement academy in the country.
Just because we're down to the last 3 weeks, don't unplug. By this point, you've got to own it.
They go through conservation law enforcement. They go through standard law enforcement.
Good.
Yeah, what's your question?
Wildlife identification.
So that's going to be the Guadalupe bass, which is the state fish.
You know, how to deal with hunters and anglers. I mean, really the gamut.
We're giving the cadets a basic understanding of swift water awareness, what the water does, how to react. All right, go ahead.
Right step, step. Right step, step.
And it's an eye-opener for them. You look at it and you think, oh, it doesn't look that bad.
Get him up! Get him up!
And they get in it and they realize, oh my gosh, this is a lot harder than I thought. Hold him up! Get back. Fight it. See what happened right there? They got turned around. What should they have done? Just turn around and the back guy's now the front guy. It's hard, isn't it? This is the strainer. This is everybody's favorite part. If you get stuck on a strainer, I don't care how strong you are, you cannot pull yourself off of it, okay? Oh, you do not want to go under. You go under it, you die. Swim, 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 keep swimming. Keep swimming.
There you go. Definitely a little bit more difficult than I thought it was gonna be.
Pretty tired, but I do. I feel like if I ever needed this training, I have it in the bank.
Y'all wanna talk a little bit more or y'all wanna figure out where you're going? All right. Nathan Lavender. A lot of game wardens, a lot of people that work for us, grew up, it's their dream. So it's truly, when they graduate, today when they get that assignment, it's a dream come true for them. Zachary Stevenson, Duval County.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Every person that graduates from this academy gets to serve a mission. It's the mission of protecting the natural resources of Texas, helping the communities that they live in, responding during some of Texas' darkest hours. But that core mission of protecting our national resources, I mean, what could be more important?
Duval County, it's very rural, and pretty much the population pretty much doubles or triples every deer season. It's a deer hunting county, and that's what it is, and that's what it's known for. There's no place to stop to get food around here either. You better pack a lunch or you won't have one.
The moments that make up our lives don't all unfold the same way. Some happen by chance.
Shoot something?
Yes, I did. Got a green teal.
Green wingtail.
Green wingtail.
Right step, step!
Some only happen through hard work.
Right step, step.
And every so often, we get a little help along our journey.
It was a great experience being able to do that duck hunt with my mom. You know, it was totally out of her element. And I don't know if I could get her into a pair of waders now, but I'm so thankful she got into a pair for me back then.
What are you feeling right now?
Just pride. Just so happy for him and so excited for his future and where he's going to go.
I plan on retiring in this job. It's something I really love to do. All right, guys, State Game Warden, we're gonna do a quick compliance check. Can everybody pull out their hunting license? Looks like you had a pretty good morning.
Appreciate it, yes, sir.
The same opportunities that were provided to me when I was a child, I wanna make sure those same opportunities are available for the next generation. And that's why I do what I do.